Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. This is my mass rocket stove mass heater that I built a couple years ago. I'm out here in my shop, uninsulated, semi-trailer, long sleeve sweatshirt, no hat, very comfortable. It's burning pellets. When I'm done here, I'll show you how that's happening. Everybody wants to know, how fast do these things burn pellets? Well, this one eats a 20-ounce iced tea can full in 7 minutes. 7 minutes, 20-ounce iced tea full. That's a 2-inch square tube, a foot long, burns in 7 minutes. In other words, that bag is not going to last me a lot of days if that's what I'm using for fuel. Now, on the other side, this stove is roasty serious hot right now. And I want to show you something again about my chimney. So I'm going to go outside and show you something about my chimney. All right, I keep harping about how these stoves should just about gravity feed their exhaust. And there is proof positive right there. Right here, you'll see I have a 5-inch stack sitting on top of a 4-inch elbow. So there is no secure connection there. There's no gas tight fit whatsoever. It does take the fumes out. But I can pull this elbow out, and I'm not going to because it's all hooked up. But I can pull this elbow out of here, and this stove will still run fine. The only reason I have the stack on the side of this semi is because on a regular basis, the wind comes from this side, and that provides me with a windshield to keep this stove from backdrafting into the shop when the wind hits the end of this chimney. I could just as easily dump that chimney down and underneath, but I really don't want the fumes coming up underneath the trailer where I might have to breathe them. So I send them up. They do not go to the top of the trailer. They stop about 10 inches short. And as you see, no smoke. Now you can see the ripples of the heat going out the top. This pipe is cool enough. I can have my hand on it. It's not a problem. Right past the end of the stove, I have lost the heat already into my shop. If your stove is burning at best efficiency, your chimney will be almost too cold to draw a draft. Now, when I've shut this fire down tonight, I'll pull that adapter thing out and show you how simple it is to make one of these, and maybe you can do it yourself. There, it's empty down in there. I'm going to pull it out and we'll take a look at it. This is just a piece of scrap 2-inch box. And all we have on the other end is a cut 45. That's it. I aim it so that the 45 dumps into the firebox. There's a 45 on top here because I'm just too lazy to cut it square. It dumps down in there. I have it spacered up with a scrap piece of 2x4 so that it doesn't lay against the back wall of the chute. I push it all the way down to the grate. And I'll show you what the grate looks like. Okay, this is what the grate looks like. It's not angled like this, but it's just expanded metal. These holes are 1/2 inch wide, 1 inch long, and they allow the pellets to build up on top. Underneath this is another grate that's a slotted grate with 1/2 inch slots that go straight down. So as soon as these pellets burn, they drop down into the ash bin, where they continue to add heat. down in the bottom until they're fully burned up. So we don't have a bunch of pellet holes left in the bottom, but that's all it is. It's just expanded steel. It's not 1/8 inch thick. I'd say it's probably 16 gauge. Okay, now, and something else somebody asks regularly, how much heat do these things put out? Now, there it is. It's taller than I am, so it's right at 6 feet tall. It's, I don't know. I'll throw a tape measure on it here. I haven't measured it in so long because it's been so long since I built it. It's 1 foot in diameter, 12 inch diameter, 6 feet long. Most of the bottom of it down here, or at least the bottom foot and a half or so, is full of insulation until you get up to the firebox. In actuality, it's full clear up to where the chimney goes out. Don't make you seasick, I'm sorry. Okay, the bottom 2 feet. The bottom 2 feet is full of perlite and insulation just simply because the chimney comes up most of the way in the middle, that heat riser. It does not come up within 2 inches at the top. It just comes up in there. Now, my exhaust exhausts out about a foot higher than my firebox goes in. And I wouldn't have had to do that. I could have put that lower. But when I built it, I didn't. Still, how much heat does it put out? Okay, over here on the box, I have a 35,000 BTU propane heater. 35,000 BTUs. I came in here and I fired that up while I got this other stove going. I shut this off. I am absolutely every bit as warm right now in this shop, maybe even warmer still, than if I had this propane heater going. The propane heater will burn one of these 20-gallon propane bottles in about 12 hours if it's full running. So, $20, give or take a little bit, $15 every 12 hours of runtime. This critter over here will run forever for free if I go out and harvest the twigs. Or it'll run on these pellets about a can every 10 minutes, 9 minutes, something like that, and make the same amount of heat. And I pay a little over $4 for a 40-pound bag. Now, I'll figure out how many bags and how long it would take, but I can pretty well say that it's not going to take 4 bags to keep this place warm for 12 hours. It's not going to take 4 bags of pellets. And typically, I wouldn't burn pellets at all, except that we got an ice storm and a snowstorm, and all of my brush is either wet or it's covered up with snow. And it's also cold outside. So, there you go. How long will it take to burn the pellets? That's how long it takes. This is a 4-inch chimney. So I can reasonably expect the Omega stove doesn't have near as much of a draw or a lift, that the Omega stove should burn them at a much slower pace than that, but it won't have 35,000 BTUs of heat energy, I expect, either. Anyway, there's my update. Why isn't it in my house? Because my insurance company that insures my home says I can't have one. And the guy that asked the question doesn't understand that my mortgage company says I have to have insurance. So if I don't have insurance, then the mortgage company will call in the mortgage. You know, I can't afford to pay for my house all in one chunk. That's why I have a mortgage. So there are times in our lives when we just have to bite the bullet and do things a certain way to keep other people happy, just simply because if we don't, we have no place to live.
Kevin Bacon. Bye for now.